Just talking about your character.
We were just talking about your character. Yeah. We were wondering, do you think Bennett witches or some other Bennett witches are going to show up in Mystic Falls this weekend?
That's a great Carolyn Trees question, funny you should ask. I don't know. It'd be nice to see some more witches, but I don't know if the witch category is kind of filled by these new heretics that are coming in.
Yeah.
So we'll have to see. I mean, there's definitely going to be some witch action, but in terms of the Bennett, I don't know. You might have seen the last of them. So.
In terms of romance for your character, is that something that you want her? You want to see her do?
Like,
or is that, would you rather be more independent?
Well, I think you can be independent and still have love in your life. I mean, I'm a very independent woman, and I still feel like I live my life in an open heart. I think it is important, especially as an African American woman on television, to show characters that are three-dimensional and to show that, you know, you can still be a force and you can still be someone to be reckoned with. You just have to meet your match.
Speaking of, the fans really fell in love with the relationship between Bonnie and Damon this past season and the way that their friendship grew. Where do you see their relationship going? Do you think it will stay just friendship? Do you think that they're a lot of people?
I think the writers are prepared either way. I think they're prepared to take us in a romantic direction if they were so inclined to do so. And I also think that they're prepared to keep us in kind of the friend box. I am personally just, I just really want to see the character explore. You know, she's somebody who is kind of similar to me in the way that she's never really been with like one guy, you know. There's still so much room for her to grow sexually, and I think especially a witch is such a sexual character, it can be, especially with spells and all that kind of stuff, and I'm hoping that they explore that side of the character. I'd be surprised if they didn't do that at all this season, to be honest. I think that would be a mistake.
So far they said there's three episodes, so where is your character now in the three episodes you've received so far?
I shot my first scene yesterday.
Oh, okay.
And I haven't read the other two scripts because I don't like, there's so much going on in the first episode that I have to kind of do my coaching and prep in order because I'm a Virgo and I can't. I just can't. This is the first time the characters are returning to Mystic Falls. So you get to see how it is and how life is. Really, not just some of the characters returning to Mystic Falls, and then some of them have been there and have had to make decisions about, you know, what is happening in the town now that the heretics are there.
Are you excited to play the best friend aspect with Caroline again? Are you excited for this scene?
I'm always excited about any sort of girl power moment. I really hope that they explore that more this season, because something that someone told me was that they loved how much the girl bonding happened on the show, which was, I think, what Nina and I did so well at, because there was such a genuine connection there that I will deeply miss. I'm hoping that, you know, I have more scenes with Annie, who plays Damon's mother. I think she's phenomenal, and I think she's got a lot to contribute to the show. So we're going to see some, like, badassness for sure. It's just a show of badass women.
What are your favorite TV shows right now?
I love Mr. Robot. I actually tune in live for it if I can. I love Game of Thrones. And I love Orange and Black. I can keep going, but I just watch a lot of television. I don't understand people at all. I don't have time to watch TV. It's like you're on TV. It's like being a music artist and like never going to see concerts, going to see other musicians. It just strikes me as odd.
You were on your own so much last year. How good is it to be back with these guys?
I love working by myself. I'm my favorite actress. So happy to go back. I'm like, oh, really? I'm kidding. No, I spent a lot of time, but it got lonely, which obviously I used in the scenes, and that was really hard. The hardest stuff was doing scenes where I'd be around other people, and I'd not be there. I'd not be visible. That was a bit of a mind fuck. But it's nice to be around the cast again, and obviously to have scenes with them. It's going to be really fun. There's such a different dynamic between Bonnie and each character, different energy between them, that it's going to be fun to explore each one of those and kind of do more of it and see what happens. I'm excited to just shoot more.
Over the last, since, you know, season one to now, what has been the one thing that you've learned in working on The Vampire Diaries that you think you'll take, you know, moving on from The Vampire Diaries? What's the one thing?
Vampire Diaries is actually one of the hardest shows to be on. It's extremely difficult. I mean, literally, we get our scripts, sometimes we get like day of changes, just like most TV shows, but we have like period. A lot of stuff taken from this. There's a lot of effects, special effects. It's dramatic. The schedule's really intense and ambitious. It's like boot camp, you know. Much stricter on set than I used to be. I think I'm a fun person, but I'm very strict. I get on set, I'm like, let's do this. We don't have a lot of time. We want to get as many great shots as possible. And we have to like move quick because there's so much action to do, and you know, some of these stunts take forever, especially like any stuff that I have to do because there's all this post effect.
Yeah.
I've never been on a show like this, and I've never worked on a show, the other shows that I've been on previously, and even films I've done. So I'm hoping that that I'm able to be on other shows that are as this kind of put together.
Mm-hmm.
No dick, no.
Are the spells hard for you to, because I mean, they're made up spells, but, you know, you kind of
have
to...
They used to be hard on me, and now we've just been kind of repeating a couple. I'm hoping I get... Y'all know Fesmatosa, you know. So I think we're going to get some new ones, hopefully. So we'll
cool.
see. She hasn't been doing that many spells.
Yeah. Well, hopefully we'll see more.
That's it, really.
Yeah.
I'm doing it now, you know, I've always, I think the reason why I wanted to continue on the show also was that we had a discussion with me and the network about the other things that I'm doing, you know, that the schedule would allow, and I didn't want to be on a show and not feel like I could still do my music and still release my singles, and I have a single coming out on the 21st, and I have a film that's in pre-production now, the Tammy Terrell titled Biopic, so, and an animated film that I'm doing from So between that and my album coming out in September, I don't feel like I'm not doing it, you know. I'm hoping that my idea of this artist that is able to do like the singing and the dancing and the acting kind of like Josephine Baker, the Shirley Temple, kind of even Will Smith, and that kind of idea of an artist comes to fruition.
Can you tell us a little bit more about your album?
Sure. Well, the second single is coming out on the 21st, and that's with Babyface singing with me on it, which is really cool. The title, my fans are actually releasing that, so I can't tell you because they have ownership on that.
Oh, okay.
yeah, they are releasing it. So, basically, it's a whole 90s album. I'm a 90s kind of girl, 90s culture.
Yeah.
You know? And I wanted to do something that felt like throwback, throwback Janet, you know, TLC, who I sampled their song from What About Your Friends from my single 1991.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to hear a lot of like melodies, old school vibes, but still in a fresh, kind of funky way.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a really fun album. I'm excited.
Awesome.
You're stuck in the 90s too long.
This will be in the 90s. I'm cool. Leave me there. I'm fine. I'm good. I'm fine. I actually brought a lot of my own clothes to set, so some of the stuff I was actually with all my stuff.
That is cool.
Biker shorts were definitely
mine. I was going to ask you that. Like, you in terms of style, like, you do tend to rock a little more, like, 90s inspired.
Yeah. Crop tops are kind of my thing, and like chunky heels, and I like my perfect style icon would be like Linda Evangelista when she did like anything.
Yeah.
You know, because it was still kind of cool and hip for the time, but it was still kind of like now you look at it and it looks like slightly dated, but in a classic way. So.
Right.
Does Bonnie's wardrobe, like her modern wardrobe, just kill you? It's like so different.
No, it makes you kind of not as attached to it, like in wardrobe things. I'm like that. I can't put on anything, because I would never wear this. So it doesn't really matter. I as long as it kind of stays in the vein of the character, I feel totally fine. But they one time tried to put me in like patent leather boots or something, and I was like, it was like first season, they hadn't really kind of figured it out, and I actually told them no, but I'm like, can I actually take them though? I have a squat tonight, you know? So, yeah, it helps you not be attached to a character. I find like a lot of actors start to get a little finicky when they're basically dressing themselves, and that for me is so boring. I'm not interested in playing myself. That's not
right.
Okay.
Any other final questions?
Oh, I think we're done.
Yeah,
I think we're done.
Sorry. Thank you. Good luck.
I think I bored them.